The SUMIFS function is what you'll want to use to add only values that meet specific requirements, very much like the SUMIF function, except you can include multiple criteria for your if statements. Let's take a look. Let's say we want to sum the total sales amount for employee Emerson. So start by typing equals SUMIFS. And the first argument is the sum range. Now this will be the range of values that will be added. In this case, we need to select the data in the sales column. Then add a comma. The next two fields are criteria range 1 and criteria 1. So criteria range and criteria work as a pair. So the first is the data range where Excel will look for the criteria, and the second is where you'll state what that criteria is. And you can create up to 127 of these criteria pairs. So in this example, because we want to sum the amount for a specific employee, our first criteria range will be the employee column. Then add a comma. And the first criteria will be the name of the employee that we want to add up the values for. In this case, that's Emerson in quotation marks because it's text. And press enter, and our total is 19,365, which we can confirm if we filter our data by Emerson. Let's add a second criteria. So come to the end of your formula and add a comma. So let's say we want to sum the amount Emerson did for shirts. This means that for our second criteria range, we'll need to select the cells in the product column. Add a comma, and for our second criteria, we'll type shirts in quotation marks. Press enter, and our result is 11,142. Let's say we instead need to pull Emerson's expenses for the shirts. To do this, we need a new SUMIFS function because the expenses will be a new range of values to sum. And while you can have multiple criteria, you can only have a single range of values to sum. So type equals SUMIFS, and in the expenses tab, we'll select the data in the expenses column for the sum range. Add a comma, and criteria range 1 will again be the employee names, because we need to filter for Emerson again. So criteria 1 will be Emerson in quotation marks, but then our criteria range 2 will be the product column from the sales tab. And for criteria 2, we'll again do shirts in quotation marks, and the expenses for his shirts are $1,171. And he only sold shirts in February and April. So if we filter Emerson in the expenses for February and April, we see that it is $1,171. So important to note here, the values being summed and your criterias do not need to be adjacent to one another or even in the same sheet. They do, however, have to be the same length of cells. And it's critical that the data be listed in the exact same order so that it references the correct result. Take a look here. If any of the selected ranges that we're using in our formulas are not the same length as the others, you'll get an error. One way you can help avoid this is by converting your data to a table if it's not already. Once it's in a table format, Excel automatically expands any ranges referenced in that table, but only for that table. Let's delete the subtotal, and notice if I add a new row here and plug in an additional sales amount for Emerson shirts, this amount updates. The expenses formula, however, displays an error because the selected data ranges are now of different lengths. To fix this, we need to come to the expenses tab, and let's make that into a table as well, and then add a row here so that all the data ranges referenced in the formula for the expenses contain the same number of rows. And because the expenses formula references data from separate sheets, I'm also going to label this row for Emerson May 2020, even though I don't have an expense amount. I'm doing this so that it matches the corresponding cell in the sales table. Keeping the data in the same order is important to avoid errors when referencing across separate data ranges. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.